I'm really proud of the progress SVS has made as a speaker brand. You know, we're really in the conversation with the world's finest speaker brands. We launched our Ultra Evolution speakers last year to incredible critical acclaim. But there's just something different when SVS launches a new line of subwoofers. It's different, it's special. The world takes note.
You know, we are a very restless company. I think we've said that before. And when we do a new series of subwoofers, it's never, and any product really, it's never a just rebadge of an existing series. It's a completely new technology platform, a reimagination of what's possible from a performance standpoint. And today we're talking about the next step in that, our 5000 Revolution series subwoofers. And why 5000 series?
And what about why 5000 Revolution? Because one thing we learned with previous product launches, you gotta know, when SVS launches a new series of products, we really rethink it from the ground up. And sometimes with our naming, we don't get the message across and people just think it's a nicer version of the previous model. And nothing could be further from the truth. 17 Ultra Revolution has taken the world by storm, and it is a complete reimagining of what it replaced. And that is even more true of the new 5000 Revolution subwoofers, which, yes, a restless company, because they completely reimagined what a subwoofer can be anywhere near that price range.
Now, it's easy to say we're bringing reference experiences to more people than ever. But what exactly does that mean?
Well, first of all, I think you kind of alluded to this. We are a very restless company. In other words, what we did before, we have zero allegiance to when we launch a new product. And 5000 Revolution subwoofers is absolutely an example of that. We took everything we learned from 17 Ultra Revolution and applied it. And I mean everything we learned. And what we have with 5000 Revolution is a completely new and reimagined driver, a completely new power amplifier. In fact, it's dual mono, it's four amplifiers bridged into two. Marry that up with unprecedented DSP processing power, more than five times the previous generation's processing power, an incredibly sophisticated power supply, which we'll talk about later in the video, that allows the subwoofer to act at peak performance regardless of what current or voltage it's faced with, regardless of what content or how loud the user plays it. It is unflappable and delivers reference experience both for movies, but also with the nuanced detail that you want for music.
Now, you had mentioned the previous reference series are 16 Ultras, and these are now the 5000 Revolution series, which are not our flagship models, but how would you say they compare to the 16 Ultras, which, again, previous reference series?
Should I say this? I mean, I actually think that 5000 series are better in every way than our previous reference, the 16 Ultra. They're better in the sense that their output is right there with them, but the nuances, the detail, the musicality, the accuracy, the sophistication of the DSP, the power supply, the control, the low frequency extension, it's unprecedented, even in a reference speaker. But now it's in our speaker that is one down from our reference models. Really something that's never, in our opinion, never been done before.
I think you checked all the boxes there.
Smith, we talked about bringing reference experiences to new price ranges. Let's talk about how we got there and why we got there. And you know, the end result was several phone calls from you to me saying, are you sure this is going to be a level of reference performance never brought to this price range? How did we do all this?
So yeah, we had this great opportunity to try and figure out how to take the amplifier we developed for the 17 Ultra Revolution and bring it to a smaller cabinet, a smaller system, but still capitalize on all the technology.
So the 17 Ultra Revolution amplifier was groundbreaking in so many ways. Did you have to compromise in order to make it work in the price ranges of 5000 Revolution, or is it basically the same?
It is almost exactly the same.
Wow.
And so with the smaller driver and a re-engineered voice coil in the 5000 series Revolution subwoofers, we had to adjust the amplifier, but only very slightly. And so it's delivering 2,000 watts of continuous power and over 5,000 watts of peak power. And that design is still using the dual mono amplifier architecture.
So it's actually four amplifiers bridged into two, dual mono amplifier driving dual voice coils in this driver.
It's delivering, I would argue, a new level of power and a new level of extension and output for the size of the product that we weren't able to achieve before.
So part of why we brought you here from Nevada, because some of this I could have explained, but I need you to explain this sophisticated power supply that we developed.
So the power supply, it takes your AC voltage from your mains outlet, and it runs it through a two-stage power factor correction that
essentially a line conditioner.
Which is essentially a line conditioner, and it converts it to DC. That DC is very efficiently cleaned and then rebuilt into the AC that the amplifier needs. That's where the eight MOSFETs, the 200 volt MOSFETs come into play.
So you're saying it is a Class D amplifier, but then the output stage, which we have done in the past, is essentially big MOSFET transistors, which are capable of gobs and gobs of current, so they can really, A, get the maximum out of the driver, but also the best control of driver, right?
Yep, absolutely.
So we've talked about the DSP a little bit. Can you help us understand what it does? Where is it going in the different parts of the subwoofer?
Yeah, so a subwoofer is only as strong as its weakest link. And just because we have this amazing power supply with this amazing amplifier section, we also need
an amazing driver.
And an amazing driver. We also need this cutting-edge DSP to manage all the different parts of the system. And so the DSP isn't just taking your various inputs, RCA, XLR inputs, and then running them through the system. It's also monitoring every part of the power supply. It's monitoring every part of the driver, even the temperature inside the box. It's doing all these things in real time so that it can always deliver the optimal power, the lowest distortion, the cleanest output, faithfully reproducing the content that you're asking the subwoofer to perform.
So this sophisticated DSP also allows us to really optimize on what's possible with, everyone loves the SVS subwoofer control app, and now we've added new features to it, including auto room EQ, which we will be launching with 17 Ultra Revolution and 5000 Revolution subwoofers.
Yeah, one of the best things about this incredible DSP is that we can unlock it to the customers.
It's fun to use. It's not like you don't need to be a scientist to use it, right?
That's right. We really wanted to make sure that it was a really easy way to approach a subwoofer from your listening position and tune the subwoofer for whatever your application, be it home theater, two-channel, and all of the features that are within the app are directly controlling features within the DSP. So when you're talking to the subwoofer through the app, you're talking directly to that DSP and modifying the subwoofer's performance according to your preference.
I know there was a lot to absorb in this video, and the reason is the technologies we're presenting in with 5000 Revolution subwoofers are unprecedented. There's a lot to talk about. I encourage you to drill into it on our website and watch our other videos. It's two different models. It's our SB5000 Revolution featuring our all-new 15-inch driver and our PB5000 ported version featuring, again, the same all-new 15-inch dual voice coil driver, same amplifier. And you know, if I were going to leave you with a conclusion, we're trying to bring reference experiences to more people by making them within financial reach of pretty much everyone, and 5000 Revolution absolutely does that. They play as loud as the user wants. They go with unprecedented low frequency extension. But they always do it with accurate frequency response, speed in the transients, so that they are musical, nuanced, detail, convincing. And finally, because of this sophisticated DSP that we deploy, they seamlessly blend into the home theater or two-channel system that they're used in and create an experience that is unforgettable, but always true to the content.